Did you ever see any of Fred's experiments yourself?
Yes. I actually helped him collect samples for his research sometimes.
To learn about them?
That's right. We found all sorts of things. One time, we went to the forest and found a small pool of water that was full of eggs.
Eggs? Were there chickens in the forest?
No, not chicken eggs. These were small and jelly-like. Hundreds of them. Fred told me that they were frog eggs. He was in for a surprise, though. Guess what happened?
What? What happened?
Well, he took some eggs back home, and one day, Fred woke up with bites all over his body. Turns out, it wasn't frog eggs after all. It was mosquito eggs.
Ah, poor Fred.
I know. He did find real frog eggs eventually. He told me that they were very, very special. But I don't know what happened to them.
Yeah.
These blue lights. Did Fred put them here? Or was somebody else here as well?
Hello, who are you? You're not from here. Wow, you look just like Fred, but smaller, and with less hair on your face.
She knew Fred. I told her that he was my uncle, and that I was looking for him.
What's an uncle?
I said that he was, that I had known him all my life.
Really? Me too. I'll help you find him. I'm Madeline. The others call me Mad Maddie sometimes. I don't know why, really, but you can call me Maddie. You've never been to the village, right? Let's meet over there in the square. I'll show you around. I bet you can get there easily with your suit thing. So, I'll see you there.
I couldn't believe it. An underground village inhabited by frog people, or more like salamanders. Either way, they walked like humans, they talked like humans. How is that possible?
Hey! Hi.
Welcome to my village. This is the town square, and that over there is Fred's tent.
I haven't seen him in a few days, though.
Maybe our elder Samuel knows where he is.
He knows a lot of stuff. Mostly boring stuff, if you ask me, but it's worth a try.
Before asking him, though, you should check out the village. It's not so bad.
Unless you have to stay for too long.
When you're done, go to the island with the windmill, and you'll see Samuel's cope from there.
I'll go on ahead and tell him that you're coming. He's not much for surprises.
Later!
I thanked Madeline and agreed to meet her later. It was strange. How could I talk to someone who was not even human and still feel like it was perfectly normal? It looked like most of the shacks in the village were built out of trash. Trash from our world. It was, after all, a garbage disposal pad that took me here.
For how long had Fred been gone?
I'm not sure. A couple of months, I think. Less than half a year for sure. I remembered hiking with him the summer before, but when I counted the days in his journals and from when I last saw him, it didn't make sense. Maddie said that she had known him all her life. Maybe she meant it figuratively. Like, she didn't really mean it. Like, when you say you'll die if you don't get a puppy for your birthday.
That's true, though.
I'm sorry. Of course it is. Thank you.
A stranger in our halls. Welcome. Our name is Samuel, and we will do our best to assist you. Please tell us what brings you here.
I told him that I was looking for my Uncle Fred.
We should help. Do you know where he is?
Fred left us without a word. If you aspire to find him, we can share with you a sacred crystal, a power core. Fred used their kind to power his suit. You can have it if you return our Fred to us.
The crystal? Sweet!
Madeline, that was inappropriate. Your help will not be necessary. The crystal is not for you to have.
What? I want to help finding Fred. Why couldn't I?
Please, Madeline, that is impossible. None of us may enter the chasms. It is too dangerous.
What's the danger? If Fred can do it, so can I.
I say this for your own protection, Madeline. You are forbidden from entering the chasms.
Just because you're afraid of what's outside the village doesn't mean I am. I'm nothing like you. I'll never be.
We apologize. It is true that we want to keep her safe. But she does not understand. Behind us is the power core. Take it, then go into the chasms. Find Fred, and if you see Madeline, take care of her. Be safe.
I felt a little uneasy about moving on into the chasms. If it was too dangerous for Maddie, would it be safe enough for me? Thank you. It's getting late, honey. Should we continue tomorrow?